So, what is the difference between clicking these two buttons here, Q as well as export? Well, for the longest time ever, whenever I would render a video, I'd instantly click export. But then I always used to find that that would take quite a lot of time because it would end up not allowing me to go in and do anything with the actual Premiere sort of like program itself, and it would tend to slow down my computer. Whereas if you go into Q right here, what this will do is it will open up Media Encoder, and what you're actually going to find here is basically a queue. So you can list up a bunch of different videos that can then be queued overnight. So this is great if you have, say, like 3-4 videos that you've batch recorded for your YouTube channel. You can actually do this and store them one by one where they individually want to be sent to with their individual presets, and then in one go you've managed to render all of your videos rather than manually doing it every single time per sequence, and then actually having to, you know, create the different export settings and render. This just saves a bunch of time. Now, two of the main reasons why I like to use this over export. The first is that once this is actually rendering here, I can actually still get access to my feed right here. I can actually look through my timeline, which I find is really, really great when I actually want to go ahead and start making the thumbnail. So instantly I can come through, I can scrub through my timeline to find a you know, a single frame that looks great. I can then click this button here, export that frame, and open up Photoshop and start working on that. I'm very big on, you know, being productive with the time when you're rendering. You know, I just think it's so much more beneficial that way, rather than actually clicking the export button. I'll show you again real quick here. Rather than just clicking that export button and then being stuck in a way, I can't get no access to that, and this could be rendering for hours depending on what kind of video that you're uploading, and so rendering, or if you have multiple videos. So for me, Q is always the best way to go. I think it's so much better having it in Media Encoder. Now, this is just a side note when it comes to exporting. A lot of people don't actually know this, but it's a little tip from me to you. If you go into editing, come down to preferences, and make sure that this is ticked here. Start queue automatically when idle for 1 minute. I automatically change this to 0, so that the second that I am happy with all of my settings in my timeline and I click queue, it will actually go straight through and begin rendering all of those videos that I may have queued up. This is just something that is great because the amount of times that I've set something up like that, there we go, see, it automatically starts doing it. The amount of times I've clicked something to go into my queue like this and then gone, okay, that's great, I'm going to go and start making that thumbnail, or I'm going to go get some lunch or something like that, and come back like an hour later and I'm still sat on a screen where it's not even began rendering, is way too many times. And it was only once I discovered that option that I changed it to 0, and it's just been a real help, and a lot of it's actually been a great time saver. So there you go, that's another little tip for me when it comes to encoding.